Hebrew Bible.
Oh shoot. I just got a new Hebrew Bible.
Where'd you get it from? Did you order?
Amazon.
How much they charge you for?
$22. We left that Hebrew Bible in the car.
They have sex with their sons and their daughters before they're even old enough to be like, they turn 3 years. I mean, how can you justify that wickedness, that evilness, bro? As a matter of fact, you can't justify it. But they use the Bible as a front. Their book is called the Talmud. Their holy book is their unholy book of the Talmud. I can see what you're saying, their holy book.
But it is holy to them.
No, it's unholy to them because they know. They know their God is Satan. Remember the lion Jew?
Yeah.
What's his name on?
Rabbi Finkelstein?
Yeah, he said, our God is Satan. This is our God is Satan.
It's easy to tell.
Last days, bro. All this info coming out. It's the last days we're living in. So a lot of falsehood will come out to the extreme, like you mentioned the word extreme. And the truth is going to come out extreme. You know? Because when they say the truth comes out extreme, that means we out here telling how it is. So, you know, when somebody doing wrong, nobody wants to be told they're doing wrong. Nobody wants to be corrected. You know what I'm saying? People take offense. So this truth comes out extreme also.
Hey, when the Lord and the apostles were teaching back in that ancient world, riots were breaking out.
Yep.
They caused so much chaos that the whole city would come against them and try to kill them. And they killed Stephen like that.
Yeah, you're right, bro.
Hey, look at that.
Going to?
Get that Acts 7 chapter. They killed Stephen because he was cursing them out.
Right. Let me get up.
I'm not disputing what many of you guys. What you're saying is 100% right in that Bible, that man just showed. I'm not disputing nothing.
Oh, I feel you.
I might got my own views on things, but I'm not disputing what you guys are saying.
I got you.
I see you guys around.
Okay, man. Let's keep going. Let me read this real quick. This is another Bible. How I shine.
What you do?
This is, you can go on the spectrum.
All right, so Stephen reads Acts 6. Oh, is he dead?
I'm here. I love that talking to you.
Acts 6 is 8. Stephen, full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Then there was a Roman servant of the synagogue, which is called the synagogue of Byzantines and Syrians and Alexandrians, and of them of Cynthia and Asia, and they were not able to resist the wisdom and spirit by which he spoke. Then there some poor men which said, we have heard him speak blasphemous words against Moses and against God. And they stirred him up, and stirred up the people and the elders and the scribes, and came upon him and caught him and brought him to the council.
Then they first say at first they couldn't dispute against it.
Yeah, they couldn't dispute against
it.
So
because it was the truth.
And they all snatched him up.
Right.
Pretty much arrested him. That's why people nowadays, they'll call the cops on you. Hey, they'll threaten to kill you and call the cops on you at the same time. Because all them demons is jumping on them, you know
That's
what I mean?
That's crazy.
Hey, they so bugged out, they'll pull a gun out of you and still call the cops on you. Go ahead.
Instead of false witnesses, which said, this man ceases not to speak blasphemous words against this holy place. We have heard him say that this shall die, Nazareth shall destroy this place, and he y'all change because of this.
Hey, the temple did get destroyed. In 70 AD, the actual temple got destroyed. You know what I'm saying? Cause back in the old Testament days, to get your to be forgiven of your sins, what, you had to go to the temple, right? And give up your offering. But the temple got destroyed. So now Yahushua took that onto himself. So if you believe in him, he was the ultimate offering. Go ahead. And like he said, what, your temple is your body, right?
That's right, bro.
Oh, he has seven. He tells you that in this chapter.
Go ahead. All that said, the council looked steadfast on him. Saw his face as it had been the face of an angel.
Yeah, because he was an angel. Go ahead. Yeah, that's good. That's good, baby.
Yeah, man. Oh, yeah.
You got this.
Chapter 7, then said the high priest, are these things so? And he said, men, brothers, and fathers, hearken to God of our glory, appearance to our father Abraham, which was in Macedonia, before he was built in Paran, and said unto him, get thee out of thy country and go from thy kindred and come into the land which I show thee. This came thee out of the land of the Chaldeans and dwelt in Paran. And from thence, when his father was dead, he removed him from his place wherein he now dwelt, where he gave him more inheritance in it.
So the land was given to Abraham. Read that part again. And his seed after him.
When he gave him none inheritance in it, no, not so much as he set his foot on it.
And that's why Stephen didn't say our forefather Esau, our forefather Ham, did he? He always mentioned Israel, our forefather Jacob, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. The Lord ain't dealing with all nations. Go ahead.
With possession into a seed after him, but as yet he has no children. He asked back on his wives that his seed should sojourn in strange land, that they should bring them into bondage and treat them evil for him near.
Yeah, that was talking about the Exodus. Because the Israelites were enslaved by the Egyptians for 400 years. Go ahead.
The nation to whom they shall be in bondage will I judge, say God, and after that shall they come forth to serve me in this place. And he gave them the covenant of circumcision. And so Abraham begat Isaac and circumcised him the eighth day. And Isaac begat Jacob. Jacob begat the 12
patriarchs. Yeah, patriarchs. Yeah, the word patriarchs, that comes from the word padre, which means father. So patriarch, it means father. Arch means leader, so it means like the leader of your fathers. You're the patriarch, that's your forefathers. Yeah, why did it say the forefathers? It didn't say the patriarchs were none of these heathen nations, okay? Go ahead.
The patriarchs moved with envy so just up into Egypt, but God was with him and delivered him out of all his afflictions. He gave him favor and wisdom in the sight of Pharaoh, king of Egypt, and he made him governor over Egypt and all his house. As it came a death over all the land of Egypt, and Canaan, in great affliction, and our father's house was suffering. And when Jacob heard that there was corn in Egypt, he sent out our father's first. And at the second time, Joseph was made known to his brothers. And Joseph's kindred was made known to
him. Go ahead. Oh, yeah.
Then sent Joseph and called his father Jacob to him and all his kindred threescore and 15 souls. So Jacob went down into Egypt and died, and he, our fathers, and were carried over into Shechem, the land of the sepulchre that Abraham bought for a sum of money of the sons of Amor, the father of something.
You can just skip it. Yeah. Yeah, I guess that was kind of long. But we can read all that, though. I mean, that's good to read all that history, man. You know what I'm saying? Because you got to know the history of your people. And Stephen, he was just re-emphasizing the history and just reminded y'all where the hell y'all came from. Go ahead.
It says, says, ye stiff neck and uncircumcised heart and ears, do you always resist the Holy Ghost as your fathers did, so do ye.
Yeah, right, because our people, they resist the Holy Spirit. Hey, just like when the Israelites went through the Red Sea, when they was out in the wilderness, they was begging to go back to Egypt. You know what I'm saying? They was saying they say Egypt was better. You know what I mean? Go ahead.
Which of the prophets?
Hey, America's a modern day Egypt. But what do people choose? To be an American or an Israelite? They'd rather be an American.
Egypt.
They want to get that money. And you see what's on that money, that Egyptian pyramid. That's the spirit. These people got the spirit of the ancient Egyptians on them.
That's insane.
Yeah.
Here.
Look like an Indian. Yeah, because these people, man, they love to worship their oppressor. You know what I mean?
I can't wait to get their social security check tomorrow first.
Yeah, they all suffered from Stockholm syndrome.
Child support usually comes through that time too. Child support comes in twice a month for this bitch. Anyway, she checks up. Let's keep it going.
Acts
7:51, stiff neck and uncircumcised heart.
Yeah, because a lot of people are stiff neck and uncircumcised. Hey, to be uncircumcised means that you're filthy and you're foul. You know what I'm saying? And our people are filthy. They're uncircumcised, unclean. Go ahead.
You do always this the Holy Ghost as your father did, so do ye, which of the prophets have not. Your fathers persecuted, and they have slain them, and show before the coming of the just one, of whom we have been now the betrayers and murderers. We have received the law by the disposition of angels have not kept it. When they heard these things, they were oppressed to the heart. And being full of the Holy Ghost, looked up steadfastly into heaven and saw the glory of God, and Yahushua standing on the right hand of God. I said, behold, I see the heavens open and the Son of Man standing on the right hand of God. And then they cried out with a loud voice, clapped their ears and ran upon him with one accord, cast him out of the city, stoned him, and the witness laid down their clothes at a young man's feet, his name was Saul. And they stoned Stephen, calling upon God and saying, Lord Yahusha, receive my spirit, and kneel down and cry with a loud voice, Lord, lay not this sin to their charge. And when he had this, he said this, he fell asleep.
Yeah, so they killed Stephen for being out there on the streets teaching the word, you know what I mean? He said they gnashed their teeth at him. They said they was cut to the heart. That's what happens with people out here who can teach these, all these scholars at school.
Gnashing their teeth, they was like in a vicious mode, like, hitting, killing, screaming, drooling, spitting, you know? That's only our people that can get into that spirit.
That's a wicked, evil spirit.
Right. Let me get this up.
But that's what happened to all the prophets of the Lord. The prophets are never accepted by the mass of the people. Like we told y'all, we are the apostles, we the prophets. All right, and that's why this world doesn't accept us. You know what I mean?
This is Exodus 32:9. Oh, this is it. This is what we're talking about. Exodus 32:9, and the Lord said unto Moses, I have seen this people, and behold, it is a stiff-necked people. Now therefore let me alone, that my wrath may wax hot against them, and that I may consume them, and I will make thee a great nation. And Moses consulted the Lord his power, and said unto the Lord, why doth thy wrath wax hot against thy people, which thou hast brought forth out of the land of Egypt with great power, with might, and a mighty hand? Wherefore should the Egyptians speak and say, for mischief did he bring them out, to slay them in the mountains, and to consume them from the face of the earth? Turn from thy fierce wrath and repent of this evil against thy people. Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, thy servants.
Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel. They didn't say remember Esau and Ham. You know what I mean?
Oh, that's a dude,
What's his name?
horizontal now, the black dude.
Oh, I forgot his name.
His name is William Bell.
Oh, there you go.
William Bell. I mean, the Tom, too. I've been talking to him, too.
Oh, man.
Look. This dude is stone on bent. Esau is in the kingdom. Because I said, he's saying Esau is part of that new covenant, the new covenant. You know, the old covenant, the Lord hated Esau. You know, this dude is gone, man. He gone, man.
I ain't never seen the scriptures where it said Esau could be saved.
Right, I showed him all kind of crap, man. But, after so many, you just can't do it.
If you can't see that Israel is the Lord's people, man, you gone, man. Because when you read the Bible, it's so clear. Every page. It's just Israel.
William Bell.
William Bell.
He's a Tom, too.
That dude's a clown, man.
Yeah.
Ain't none of these people even serious. You see these people on YouTube, they pretending like they scholars. They use a bunch of big words, and they talk like nerds, like, whoa!
And he know a lot of nothing, you know what I'm saying? He knows a whole lot of nothing.
Yeah.
Which he knows a lot, but he knows a lot of nothing.
It's a lot of madness.
So look, to him, the Bible's ended. The time of the Bible ended when John was in the island of Patmos.
Yeah.
So this thing is, he's saying this is not relevant to today. He's saying ain't nothing in here is relevant to today. So prophecy is out the window. He's saying there's such thing as last days.
If there's not relevant to today, then why would Satan get locked up for 1,000 years?
Oh, he said that's coming.
He said that's coming. But
I already told him about the 1,000 years.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, because he tried to come at me in another account. Because I noticed his pattern, his speech pattern is the same. He tried to come at me in another account. Like he got somebody supporting him.
Oh, everybody does.
Right.
Here we go.
Remember Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, thy servants, to whom thou swearest by thy own self, and sayest unto them, I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven.
I will multiply thy seed as the stars of heaven. That goes into the mystery of the Gentiles, because Israel is so numerous and so... They ain't everywhere. Damn Israelites everywhere you go, man. This is all that Israel has been scattered among all the heathens. That's what y'all fools can't understand. Because y'all is fucking retarded. You know, you think you some big shot scholar or whatever, or you're a theological professor. No, you're stupid. Professing themselves to be wise, they became fools. Go ahead.
I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have spoken of will I give unto your seed. And they shall inherit it forever. You know what would be good to get when 1 Samuel, what the 2 Samuel, Saul was coming up against David. You know, that's the point we're on, Israel. I've been dumbasses and fools and shit like that, you know.
Yeah.
If you can find it. That's Israel. Just love bumping against the truth. Bumping up against the truth, brother, you know. I will multiply your seed as the stars of heaven, and all this land that I have spoken of will I give unto your seed, and they shall inherit it forever. And the Lord repented of the evil which he thought to do unto his people. And Moses turned and went down from the mountain, and the two tables of the testimony were his hand. The tables were written on both of their sides, on one side and on the other side were they written, and the tables were the work of the most high, and the writings were the writings of the most high. Graven unto the table. In the tent. And when Joshua heard the noise of the people, as they shouted, he said unto Moses, there is a noise of war in the camp. And he said, it is not the voice of them that shout for compassion, neither is the voice of them that cry for being overcome, but the noise of them that sing for joy to hear. And I came to pass, and as soon as he came nigh unto the camp, that he saw the path and the dancing, and Moses' anger waxed hot, and he cast the table out of his hands and break them beneath the mountain. And he took the calf which they had made and burned it in the fire.
Yeah, so the Israelites, it was worse than the golden calf. And Moses, he took it, he burnt the motherfucker. Then he put it in the water and made it drink the water. You know, Moses, man, was not fucking around. He wasn't like some little happy old man. Hey, he had that staff. He probably bashed you upside the head with it.
Yeah.
like you wicked ass Israelites. Did you mean, you see what Moses had to deal with? The Israelites are fucking retarded.
Right. Here they coming out the damn Egypt. They following a chariot, got protected by a chariot.
They see a chariot, they gonna worship a calf. That doesn't make no sense. But they probably have some kind of science behind that calf too though.
Yeah.
They explain to you why you gotta make the calf. They try to break it down.
I told you, you want to talk about loose springs, man.
That's an Egyptologist. They always, because they worship calves. The Egyptologists you see on YouTube, and they always get, they say there's sciences behind the apis bull, though. There's science behind the cat god and the bull god.
It was your boy, there was with Grayson, there. Said he was hanging out with Grayson. What's his name? You used to make videos against
him. Oh, Truth Irisy.
Yeah,
oh, yeah. Hey, I call him Douche Irisy.
Right.
Yeah, he's a fucking douche.
He was heavy into that shit too.
Yeah, he's still out there, bro. He's just making all kind of videos filled with nothing but madness and confusion. Just total madness and confusion. That's what you'll find on Truth Irisy's page.
Right.
Stay away from that fool.
And strawed it upon the water and made the children of Israel drink it. And Moses said unto Aaron, what did this people unto thee? Moses said unto Aaron, what did this people unto thee, that thou hast brought so great a sin upon them? And Aaron said, let not the anger of my Lord wax hot. Thou knowest the people that they are set on mischief.
He said, you know the people. And that tells you who Israelites are. They always set on mischief. They just always ready to just go do some ignorant ass shit. You know what I mean? Always plotting and scheming. Plotting on a lick. You know what I mean? That's all they thinking about.
Wait for a come up.
Yeah, all they trying to do is get that come up, and they'll do anything to get it.
By any means necessary. That's true too. You don't know that, man. You need to go just hang with them motherfuckers and just, partake in their evils.
Because that script, that Bible describes all these people we see out here. You see it.
Oh, it's horrid out here, man. It's horrid out here. That's their excuse.
These motherfuckers are just no damn good. That's all they're right here.
Shit,
take
clean. She's still at her. I can imagine how many niggas she'll screw between now and then. And Moses said unto Aaron, what did this people unto thee that thou hast brought so great a sin upon them? And Aaron said, let not the anger of the Lord wax hot. Thou knowest the people that they are set on mischief. For they said unto me, make us gods, who shall go before us. And go with them.
I got it.
For they said unto me, make us gods, who shall go before us. As for this Moses, the man that brought us up out of the land of Egypt, we wot not what is become of him. And I said, just some faithless motherfucker, just some weak faithless motherfucker, man. The man's gone for a short minute, they just want to do all kind of crazy shit.
They probably, all the Lord left us.
Right, right.
You don't even give a fuck about it. They got no faith.
This is just like these fools that used to come out, man. They're back in the world. They don't come out anymore. They just doing all kind of crazy shit, man.
Yeah, because we show them all kind of signs and wonders.
Yep.
They see all. We seen crazy fucked out shit together.
Right, right.
With these people that fell out.
Right.
You know what I mean?
They have no excuse.
You got none.
You know?
I don't know how you can turn your back on the Lord. You got to be stupid.
There's some scripture on that too. The Lord said, "Go over and turn their back."
Yep.
Some with the plow.
Yeah, you just gotta keep plowing. You gotta keep, or you just can't stop.
Right, right.
This is like that blood in, blood out thing.
We're laboring.
Laboring.
In laboring, we're working. You know, we're not vacationers. Or busybodies, or slothful men. And I said unto them, whosoever hath any gold, let them break it off. So they gave it me. Then I cast it into the fire, and there came out this calf. And when Moses saw that the people are naked, for Aaron had made them naked unto their shame among their enemies, then Moses stood in the gate. I don't mean to took off their goddamn
clothes. Yeah, I know, but he just, their whole spirit was just fucking, just killed. He just, you know, they just, Moses and it was not fucking around, man. This is like the Lord wasn't messing around. The Lord was doing the same thing. He walked up in a temple and started whipping people. And people would be like, well, y'all using curse words. Well, if the Lord was here, he'd whack you upside the head. Like, crap.
Make it sound like metal on metal.
It was straight, crack you with a whip. Hey, get that Luke 19:27. Just a quick precept.
Okay, go ahead. Go ahead.
Can you get that just a quick precept?
We like precepts around here.
Just a little quick. 19:27. Read aloud too.
But those my enemies which would not, that I should reign over them, bring hither and slay them before me.
So then, that's the spirit of the Lord's in.
That's right. And William Bell, one of his things he's pushing is the Lord adheres violence. You know, the Lord ain't with violence in no shape, way, or form.
Well, the Lord is the most violent of them all, ever.
Right. And he went through a whole list of shit while the Lord ain't violent. I was like, what the hell is he going
through? If the Lord ain't violent, then why did he destroy Sodom and Gomorrah with fire? Explain that. If the Lord ain't violent, why did he flood the whole earth and kill everybody but Noah and his family?
Ooh, beautiful. Right.
If the Lord ain't violent, how come he drowned the Pharaoh and all his army?
Violent, then why is he bringing that second death?
Yeah, why is it
fire?
Yeah, why is there something called Armageddon? People don't make no sense.
Right.
I get that Exodus 15:3 real quick.
Well, according to William Bell, it's already happened. You know?
Oh, it's already happened. It's already happened. Yeah. You see a lot lately, too.
Yep. A lot more, man.
The plague's going, because people be hearing the
word. Yep. You've seen a lot more.
Once you hear the truth, there's no going back. You know what I mean? Then the Lord will hit you with leprosy. You might catch syphilis or something crazy.
Don't be surprised if it starts to
fall. Very good. Exodus 15:3.
Exodus 15:3. Yahweh is a man of war. Yahweh is his name.
Right. Because Yahweh, that's the Most High God. The scripture says that the Most High, the Lord is a man of war. The Lord is his name. Yahweh is his name. Oh, and he told you that's my name. Yahweh is the name of the Most High, and the name of his son is Yahweh Shai. And that's the only name that you can call on. You can't be calling on the name of Jesus, Yeshua, Allah. Yeah, the Lord ain't here. No Allah, no Jesus, no Jehovah. It's Yahweh Bahasham, Yahweh Shai. That's the name of the Lord and his son. You go back, you got something back you
read? None of the goddamn East Indian gods. None of the gods of all them, all of them Hamite gods that they have.
Yeah, God's name's not God. Go ahead.
25, and when Moses saw that the people were naked, for Aaron had made them naked unto their shame among their enemies, then Moses stood at the gate of the camp and said, who is on the Lord's side? I love this, man. Who is on the Lord's side? Let him come unto me. And all the sons of Levi gathered themselves together unto him. And he said unto them, thus said the Lord power of Israel, put every man his sword by his side and go in and out from the gate to gate throughout the camp and slay every man his brother and every man his companion.
Oh, I gotta take a drink.
Every man his neighbor.
I need a drink of water after
this. Was among Israel.
Among Israel?
Among Israel.
I thought you were supposed to love all the Israelites.
Right. Love thy neighbor. Love all
of you. Oh, yeah. Everybody's your neighbor.
Love all your neighbors. Love them all. Hey, we had a moment of beer and liquor mixed in a plastic bottle, man. It was potent.
He's floating on the clouds right now.
Good, man. Real good.
Hey, that don't sound half bad. I might join him later.
Right. And the children of Levi did according to the word of Moses, and there fell of the people that day about 3,000 men.
3,000? But the Lord, all this is love of Jesus, the love of God right there. He just loved everybody right there.
Israelites.
The spread of throwing hearts and kisses at everybody.
Yeah, I'm sure they had chocolate back there. They had chocolate.
The Lord leaped down with the rainbow streak behind him. You know what I mean?
Right. This is crazy. For Moses has said, consecrate yourself today, for the Lord even every man upon his son and upon his brother, that he may bestow upon you blessing his day. I'm not sure if it goes into it.
I got that thing you were talking about with soul and David. Talking about these weak ass Israelites.
Where we at? Where you at?
Saul and David. Man, where was it?
Let's go. He's out of there. Now I don't need that, man. That page is tore up.
Somebody gonna find us a scripture.
The pages of Genesis and Snicker.
I was 2 Samuel 3:1. Because you was asking for this earlier, I think something like this. Now there was a long war between the house of Saul and the house of David. But David waxed stronger and stronger, and the house of Saul waxed weaker and weaker. You know what I'm saying? Because we're the house of David. You know what I mean? And all these people, scoffers and scorners, everybody that come up against us, they getting weaker. We getting stronger in the spirit. They getting weaker in the spirit.
That's right. That's right.
You know what I'm saying? And y'all can get as mad as you want, you coming out here against us, talking shit. It don't matter. We just going to get stronger and stronger. It ain't gonna stop. We're just gonna get stronger and stronger until we hit the kingdom. And we'll be like, pow. And when the missiles start dropping, all y'all gonna be destroyed.
I'm trying to think of where it goes into a little bit more, though. I don't think it's always that division with the house of Saul.
Yeah,
Hebrews 3:7. It says, wherefore, as the Holy Ghost said, today you will hear his voice, hearken not your hearts, as in the provocation in the day of temptation in the wilderness, when your fathers tempted me, proved me, and said, saw my works 40 years. Wherefore I was grieved with that generation and said, they do always err in their heart, and they have not known my ways. So I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest.
That's me right there.
Take heed, brethren, lest there be any of you an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God, but exhort one another daily while it is called today, lest any of you should be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. We are made partakers of Yahushua if we hold the beginning of our confidence steadfast until the end. Hebrews chapter 4:1. It says, let us therefore fear, lest their promise being made, being left us of entering into that rest, any of you should seem to come short of it. For unto you was the gospel preached as well as unto them, but the word preached did not profit them, not being mixed with faith in them that heard it.
Because it wasn't no message of goodwill, it wasn't a message of prosperity, it wasn't a will of you can do whatever you want, the Lord's going to forgive you. You know Israel, they want to hear the precepts of men, what Isaiah went into. They want to hear that message that made them feel good. But if it's a message of discipline, no, they out of there. So the Lord says, he's going to prepare you for temptations. You know, because some demons going to work on your weakness. And that's all Israel have is weaknesses, man. Evil weaknesses, man. When's a motherfucker have a problem with being brotherly as it is? Shit, the Most High gonna strike him. I thought that was girl because he said he was gonna be out here.
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, he said he was gonna be out here. Again.
Hey, where you at, Daryl?
Right. Most High gonna get him, boy. Gonna get him. You know? And that's just pretty much how I gotta start speaking now, you know? You ain't doing us no favor, you know, coming out. You ain't doing nobody a favor. You know, saying you're going to come out and don't show up.
Only pay your part of you doing a favor is yourself.
Right.
You can come out and that's all about you.
Actually, he's torturing himself. You know, you're
Planning
to come out and don't come out. You texting somebody, that ain't going to work just texting somebody say you're coming out.
Does the scripture say let every man work out his own salvation?
Yeah, man, you better get your ass out here before the Most High do work. What worse is happening to you, you're gonna do worse. Get out here and do this work, man. Get out here with your brothers. You know?
For real.
You know? Because all you're doing is showing you ain't part of the kingdom. You ain't gonna be part of the kingdom of hell. Your work wasn't complete when you stopped coming out. You know? You gotta keep coming.
You just gotta pick up that cross and get it in.
Yeah. It's common sense, man. Why are you going through all these tribulations and troubles and shit?
I'm gonna show you what the Lord said.
It's common sense. You know, you're already catching hell. You know why you're catching hell.
You guys, I got a scripture.
So you come out, he be out here, then catch me a little bit later. He's talking about my girl, baby mama now. Looking for an apartment.
So what are you saying? All this stuff is just, I mean, everybody knows it's common sense that it was written in the Bible, everything's going on.
Right. Yeah.
Right.
So is that what you're trying to preach to people that don't know?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, you commanded to come out here. You commanded to go to church. This is church out here. We in church right now.
Well, let's have church.
We in church. You know, the scripture says that the temple of God, the church, is not a building. You know what I mean?
I know that.
Well, you are the temple, right? That's what the scriptures say. So you, but really the word church.
That is part of the temple.
Oh yeah. This is the word of the Most High. But we're commanded to come out here on the streets and teach. To teach our people, because our people are retarded. They don't know nothing.
No, they don't.
So that's why we gotta teach them, you know what I mean? What are you looking for?
That's not true.
Everything on that sign is
true. I have Jewish faith.
You have a half Jewish
faith?
Yeah,
I'm
Hispanic.
You have a half Jewish faith?
Yeah.
He must
have
to be a real
Jew. That's it. But, I mean,
really.
That's what
the
rabbi
said. Yeah,
they do. Right.
You see the picture, don't you? See,
they had to pass laws against it in New York.
That's what you're not supposed to do.
I don't think they do that because my...
Look, you see the picture.
Did you go to the
right
synagogue?
Now.
Did he go to the synagogue?
Yes, he does.
They do that. They have a ritual.
I have two kids with him.
Look at the picture.
And they never did that to none of my kids.
Well, maybe the sect you don't. Maybe you're not in a real Jewish sect.
No,
they
he
do
is
that.
Jewish. And what's he's never did that to none of my kids.
See, we're not Jewish. We're Jews.
I'm not Jewish. He is. He's not Jewish.
Right. They're not the ones in Israel.
Well, maybe not all of them do it, but a lot of them don't.
Right.
They do that.
See, that's a rabbi right there sucking on that baby's penis. That's a rabbi. You see it right there, don't you? You got glasses? Any glasses?
I can see it.
Seriously, can you see it though? Look.
You get on YouTube and look up Rabbi Explains Why You Gotta Do It.
There was a rabbi came out here in front of us and told us that.
Yeah, we talked to a rabbi out here. He got mad at us because we said it was pedophilia.
Right.
And he looked at us like we were stupid.
Do you know why they do it?
To him and ask him why.
You wanna know why?
He probably knows about it.
Yeah, because he does know.
Well, listen. They do it because they say the saliva is what helped cure it.
It helped heal
the wound. Right, right.
It's starting to agree with it.
This is Hebrews 9:11. But Moshiach God being come and high priest of good things to come, by a greater and more perfect tabernacle, not made with hands. That is to say,
I'm sorry, just lock you. But when you said the saliva helps here, really, she's like, oh, that makes sense. You didn't see that look?
Yeah.
She's like, oh, okay.
Right. See, she had all kinds of people. I had sisters. See her with her sneakers? See how she had me? She's behind her, so people fucked up.
I need to get a gigantic two-thirds sign. I just need to get like a big giant pie chart on a circle on a stick. It's two-thirds. You know what I'm saying? Put a picture of the missile in it.
Oh, you're supposed to do that.
I'm
for real, bro. Make a missile sign, man.
We're gonna get one.
Three.
Yeah, because the missiles is what's coming, man. It is not a game. Because they keep, I was just reading on, on InfoWars, they came out with an article, they keep talking about it. How the biggest story of the year that nobody is talking about, it was Russia threatening to nuke the United States. Because the whole fucking, the United States got Russia surrounded.
Well,
that first one is really
clear war.
Oh, yeah.
America passed more sanctions. Those sanctions is an act of war, man.
It really is.
When you want to try and starve your people, the people out, man, that's an act of war, man.
That is an act of war.
You know?
Who's their ally?
Yeah, Russia.
China.
Right there.
Yeah. China.
Well, the Russian, the North Korean communists, all that goes back to Stalin. You know what I mean? It's all that communism. It's all, they're all friends.
They're allies.
Boy, there's gonna be a lot of missiles shot this way.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, do y'all got any missile reflectors? Some bullet, some missile proof vests?
Mama, go ahead. They said that North Korea's, their defense is worthless against North Korea's missiles.
Remember that last satellite North Korea shot up? It went stealth for a little bit.
They didn't know where it went.
Yep, it went stealth. And that's that Russian technology.
Russia got the best technology on the planet.
That's bad, man. That's bad, man. That's bad.
They don't share it either. They keep it secret.
Yeah. They letting some of it trickle out to their...
America is so stupid. They have their planes and, computer chips and shit manufactured in China by their enemy. How stupid is that? They be outsourcing fucking national defense systems to foreign countries.
And they said in order for them to, that technology they got from China, it said it's going to cost them too many trillions of dollars to go back and reverse,
reverse.
Do their own technology and get China's shit up out of there. So they can't do it. They're not going to spend the money to do it. That's money, man. Because some dumb proud motherfuckers didn't see that coming. They never thought World War III was going to be popping off one day. Caught them, got them. Fucking clowns. They go to Russia for rockets
NASA uses Russian rockets. I forgot all about that. That's some weak ass shit.
That's some mind-boggling shit. Like, why
you gotta go to the Russians for your rockets? They get tired of blown up astronauts. They get tired of seeing astronaut guts flying everywhere.
Paying too much money and millions to widowers, man. Widows. That's a lot of money.
I forgot, you're right though, they do use Russian rockets.
Yep.
How stupid is that? And they can sabotage your ass, man. Why would you trust your enemy?
You know that's coming. Now you know that's coming.
That's how I tell you how weak this country has become. This country has become weak. It's like a weak bitch.
Let me look that up. Oh, that's a...
Lift it up this curtain.
That's how I see it. As they have become as weak as these. Because they got the technology too, you know? Or better than the United States. Thou has become weak as thee or something like that. Let me see if I can find that.
Yeah, Isaiah 14.
Has thou become, is it 14?
Yeah.
That's what it sounds like.
We're talking about Lucifer.
Yeah, right. That's it, you're right.
I just start with the Lucifer part.
That is it. 10.
Isaiah 14.
Yeah. Isaiah 14 and 10. All they shall speak and say unto thee, art thou also become weak as we?
Yeah, right now this is talking to the rulership of this power right now, which is Esau. Because he's the commander of this mighty nation. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead.
Yes. All they that...
Because originally it was talking about King Babylon, right? But who's king of Babylon now? What is Babylon today? Babylon's America.
America.
It's America. Babylon means great confusion. The Bible, the book of Revelation tells you that this is great Babylon, the land of great confusion. Go ahead.
All they shall speak and say unto thee, or thou also become weak as we, or thou become like unto us, thy pomp is brought down to the grave.
Right, because this devil's proud. Esau's proud. Like you see, he's always boasted America the greatest nation on earth. It's going to continue forever and ever.
Shoot.
You know what I mean? Go ahead.
And the noise of thy vials, the worm is spread under thee, and the worms cover thee.
Yeah, so soon, yeah. It's a marriage. Yeah, it's like a zombie. You know what I mean? Not a zombie. It's like the death. It's just death.
Roll down the streets, man. Roads falling the fuck apart.
Yeah,
bridges, bricks falling off of bridges.
Yeah.
You know, the pipelines exploding, house blowing up. You know? And that's just the infrastructure. The people decaying too.
Right, it's like a dying society, a dying country.
Yep. Decaying away.
Yeah, it's decaying.
People catching all kind of infections.
Diseases.
Hell, they saying the secret virus is here now.
Yeah, we got to get people detected with Zika. A lot of children getting autism. All the women got herpes, STDs, warts. You know what I mean? They got that antibacterial resistant gonorrhea. They said that's worse than AIDS. That would just, that fuck you all up. That new gonorrhea.
Yeah.
That's that super gonorrhea.
Yeah, that's some painful shit too. It's painful. You know, I'm gonna thank the Lord. You know, I'm gonna y'all shy. I ain't never had that burning sensation.
I pray to the Lord too.
And I heard motherfuckers literally told me they were crying, peeing, man. Because it felt like needles was coming out their dick. You know?
Yeah, watch where you put it. Ooh, put your shit, God, man. You can't just slide off on up inside of everything. You gotta do everything according to the Lord.
That same motherfuckers, man, they ain't fucking men.
Yeah, because that's exactly, but that's still punishment though for adultery. If you ain't out there committing adultery, you're not being a faggot, you ain't gonna catch nothing.
Right.
And if you a man of the Lord might protect you from shit too.
Just a pussy.
Yeah, you might get lucky one night, you out somewhere, you might fuck a little whore or something. Yeah, the Lord will protect you.
Because
you gotta pray on a woman too. Just like you gotta pray before you eat, you know? Before every meal you eat, you gotta pray to the Lord. You know what I mean?
How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer?
Oh, Lucifer again today. Because Lucifer, the Lord's being sarcastic. Because the word Lucifer is not Satan, okay? Lucifer is not Satan. The word Lucifer comes from a Latin word, which meant from lux, it means light. But actually, in Hebrew, Lucifer is not there, it's halal. I'm forming the word halal, which means to praise. It's like where you get the word hallelujah, praise God. So the word Lucifer means someone who's highly exalted, highly praised, highly illuminated. That's what it means. But the Lord's being sarcastic right here when he's talking to Esau. He said, oh Lucifer, oh your great highness. You know what I mean?
What's the same words in Hebrew?
Hello, you can look it up. I have my Hebrew Bible, I should go get it. I forgot to bring it, and we had it in the car looking at it, and I forgot. You know, I was so excited.
How do you think you spell it, man?
It's H-L-L. It's from the root word, halal.
H-L-L?
Yeah, just like hallelujah.
H-L-L?
Yeah, in Hebrew. H-A-L-L-A-L. But I just know the Hebrew word. You know, Hebrew is all hitting in those bounds. Yeah, so it means, yeah, because the word Lucifer is not even in the Bible. So they say the word Lucifer is Satan. First of all, Lucifer is not even in the Bible at all. Get it out your mind. There's no Lucifer. It doesn't exist. The word for that starts at, in that with the H in the Hebrew, not an L. So that whole Lucifer thing's a whole big fairy tale made up, you know what I mean? Oh, he was the most beautiful angel. Well, actually, Esau, he thinks that he's a beautiful angel, don't he?
Yeah.
Because that's really talking about Esau.
How art thou fallen from heaven?
Yeah, like the Rothschilds, those are Lucifers. Motherfucking the Illuminati, that's Lucifer. All them devils, all the so-called Jews, all them. Yeah, that's what Illuminati means. Illuminati means the enlightened ones. And they'll tell you that they're Luciferian. What's his name? Because they know what the word means. The word, what's your dude, bro? Albert Pike. Remember him? Is that his name?
I remember Albert Pike.
He was the Freemason, right? He was a 33rd degree Freemason, like founder of the KKK.
Right. Albert Pike.
Is that his name? He wrote Morals and Dogma.
Right.
The author of Morals and Dogma, but he wrote And he said that Freemasonry is Luciferian, and it is Luciferian doctrine. It's a Luciferian doctrine. That's the wording he used. He said it's a Freemasonic, Freemasonry is Luciferian.
It's deep too.
And he knows the meaning of it.
I don't know. Just put it in the book, man.
Yeah, he ain't gonna know.
Just put it in the book. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which didst weaken the nations?
Right, because who's weakening the nations? Who do you see right now, just look at the world, who's going around the earth weakening all the other nations?
Passing all these sanctions on those fuckers.
Yeah, passing sanctions on countries, starving countries out. They've been trying to starve Persia or Iran for years and years.
It ain't working.
It ain't working.
They tried to do it with
They done conquered Libya.
Yeah.
So they done went up there, killed Gaddafi. Hillary Clinton said, we came, we saw he died. He laughed about it. They done killed Saddam Hussein.
They're behind the shit that's going on in Venezuela.
Yep, they that.
They're kind of recovering a little bit.
Well, they been said they killed Chavez.
Yeah, yeah,
they said
right.
He was
not.
Yeah.
Yep. You know they did, CIA.
Yeah, of course. CIA heavy down in Venezuela. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Because they're outside of that system. Just like, just name some more nations they don't fucked up. They've been ravaging all of Africa for years and years.
Sudan.
They're stealing all their resources. Yeah, Iraq, they took out Saddam. They up and right now support, they behind all that war in Syria. They was behind the overthrow of the governments up in, Ukraine.
Right.
We're in the Ukraine Rebellion.
Yeah.
Now they got a proxy war fighting the Russians with the Ukrainians.
I forgot where she was. I think it was Bulgarian. Maybe.
There's all these coups down there, yeah.
All through Latin America.
That's just crazy. That's wild and crazy.
So right now they're in Brazil too. And the Olympics about to jump off. They're finding dead bodies in the river day by day, you know?
Yeah, Brazil, that's you don't want to go down there.
Let's say Honduras.
Oh, yeah, Honduras. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, they've been back in the Honduras since the 60s.
They make movies out of the CIA's all through Central America and all that.
Yeah, yeah.
They just over there. That's what they did down in Cuba.
Yeah. Oh, Cuba too. Yeah. What's the Cuba, Panama?
Yeah, Panama. Oh, yeah, I watched that movie, The Panama Deception.
That's bad, ain't it?
Esau went up in Panama. This was back in, the late 80s, during the Bush administration. The Bush Senior.
What?
It was
say something. Tell me what the, you know?
We ran out of Panama
Deception. That's a man for you. That's a man for you, you know? Talking, he was pointing to you, though. Probably Esau, you know, the usual.
Hey, you see, I didn't even notice.
Right.
You see, I didn't even know what was going on.
I'm waiting for a battle, man. I'm waiting for a spiritual battle. These motherfuckers scoffing, walking by and shit. Scoff right by.
It's always the people that like to call me Esau today. They gonna stop and talk about it.
Yeah, it's the same unspiritual motherfucker.
So what does that tell you, though, what kind of spirit they got on them?
Right.
A weak bitch.
Clown.
Drive-by scoffers.
Right.
But anyway.
Go home and watch a Madea movie.
Yeah, you know that, bro.
Madea.
Madea. Probably gonna go eat some bacon.
Right.
You know, he calling people Esau, he eating bacon. Eating bacon and ham. You know what I mean? I can see the spirit of evil on these motherfuckers, bro.
Skull pride.
But it's insignificant, because what is he doing? Nothing.
Ain't never on record have we ever recorded us hitting anybody, beating motherfuckers down, jumping a motherfucker, but these motherfuckers act like we have. Where's that coming from? That's just the spirit of the Lord. You know? That's the spirit of man on us, so they gotta keep it going.
Yeah, because they've been wishing death on us and everything. Hey, the feeling's mutual.
Damn right. For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven, and I will exalt my throne above the stars of the Most High. I will sit upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the door. I will ascend above the heights of the cloud. I will be like the Most High. You know? With Russia's help, you're able to do that now. You know? With Russia's help.
But they think they're up on a high status like the Most High, because they think they like God now, because they know about DNA splicing, because they know how to genetically modify. They can tinker with the genomes and shit, you know what I mean? They can tinker with the DNA. Now they can make grapples, a combination between a grape and an apple. and they make glow-in-the-dark mice. They probably already got glow-in-the-dark people. You know they got some weird shit in the laboratory.
Can't wait to see it,
yeah, they playing God. They playing the Most High.
I can't wait to see it.
And that's why they're going to further think they're on the status of God, is when they're going to start pushing this transhumanism more and more. People are going to start getting microchips in their hands, in their brain. They're going to get cybernetic eyeballs, cybernetic hands.
Bionic man.
Yeah, bionic man. You're going to have super speed. You'll be able to jump 20 feet in the air. You know, that's what's coming. And the scriptures tells you if you accept that microchip and that transhumanism, that you're going to be destroyed forever.
Let me get this before I go on. It's Ecclesiastes 1 and 9. The thing that has been done, it is that which shall be. And that which is done, is that which shall be done. And there is no new thing under the sun.
Yeah, ain't nothing new under the sun.
Same shit they was doing before Noah.
Oh, yeah, but you don't want to know what was going on in the days before Noah.
Imagine.
It said, well, we should read that scripture real quick.
I can imagine, man, because you know, that mythical creature, the Minotaur, Benatar, whatever
yeah,
they call
that shit is real.
Yeah, that has to be. Yeah,
all
has
that
to be.
Has to be.
Boom!
Oh,
it's got hit.
Oh, shit, that's wonderful.
It's got hit. Flood, man, like I said, man, there's probably, you know, giants walking around. There's a lot of movies coming out now, like the last few years. There's been three giant movies came out. Three giant movies, man. There's probably giants walking around for so long.
BFG.
They, you know, Yeah, that's the last
I want to see that.
That's a good one. Hey, man, I'm talking about the graphics. It's tight.
I know, it just looks good,
it's
man.
It's bad, man. What's up, man? My man. You got it, bro. You got it. He gone.
Yeah, he's way past gone. He feeling nice. Hey, I got a precept for that. I'm talking about the giants. Well, that's where you get the word Nephilim, though. Genesis 6 and 4. There were giants in the earth in those days. Like, that's that word where you get the whole story of Nephilim. And we're the Nephilim. We use those giants. We use those highly statured people. You know what I mean? That when we fell away, that's the word Nephilim, or in the scriptures, Nephilim, which means to fall away from, you know, because we fell away from the commandments of the Lord. That's what it means to fall. That's a fallen angel. If you was like an apostate, somebody who, you know, you just disobeyed the Lord's commandments, you become a fallen one, a fallen angel.
Yep.
Like, you know what I mean?
Yep.
Good. You read this. That's what people don't get. They don't understand what fallen angels are. Those Israelites that lost their way. That's what a fallen angel is. There were giants in the earth in those days, and also after that, when the sons of God came into the daughters of men, and they bare children to them, the same became mighty men which were of old, men of renown. And this sons of God right here, that's not talking about the angels. Okay, that's talking about us. Who's the sons of God? I get that Romans 8 and 14. The New Testament tells you who the sons of God are. It's the Israelites.
Before the flood, man, I can imagine what they were doing.
Oh, I got it right here, too.
I can imagine. I got some pictures,
because, you know,
too.
People was living and be damn near 1,000 years old back then, 900, 800 years
right,
old.
Right.
This thing, if you alive that long and you're a studious man, you studying every day and developing technologies, just think of the kind of knowledge you would obtain from all the years to study. You know what I mean? Just think of Tesla lived to be 900 years old. What do you think he would have accomplished? You know, that's what you gotta think about, shit like that. So the earth must have been fucking bugged out, futuristic, crazy as hell. That's where that myth of Atlantis comes from. You know what I mean? That's going way back to the flood story. This super highly advanced civilization. It was just bugged out technology to blow your brains. You got something? Yeah, Romans 8 and 14.
Romans 8 and 14. For as many as dead by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God.
Keep going.
For ye have not received the spirit of bondage again to fear, but ye have received the spirit of adoption, whereby we call Abba Father. The Spirit itself bear witness of our spirit, that we are the children of the Most High.
See, the Spirit, bears witness our spirit that we're the children of the Most High. I think there was one more to that, wasn't it?
Children, heirs, together.
Well, that was the point. It said that we the sons of God. And that's what Genesis 6 is talking about. Okay? When the sons of God, when they took those children of children of men, that means they was having sex with the heathen nations. You know, with the other, because before the flood, you had the different heathen nations, and then you had the sons of God. And just like today, you wasn't supposed to be having sex with heathen women. He said, and they bare children for them, the same became mighty men, which were of old, men of renown. That's when they start probably made up the stories about them. You get a lot of myths from them shits, you know what I mean? It said, and God saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. So that was, you can see that repeating itself today, can't you?
Amazing.
You see it. It said that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. And it repented Yahweh that he made man on the earth, and it grieved him at his heart. That's how the Lord is disgusting. But the Lord is all love, and he repented that he was created. What kind of sense does that make? And Yahweh said, I will destroy man whom I have created from the face of the earth, both man and beast, and the creeping thing in the fowls of the air, for it repenteth me that I have made them. But Noah found grace in the eyes of Yahweh. And then it goes in to tell you about how the Lord destroyed Noah. I mean, he did not destroy Noah. He destroyed everybody but Noah and his family. You know what I'm saying? And Satan came by distracting me, messing up my speech.
There you go. First Chronicles 1:20-6. And yet again there was war in God. There was a man of great stature, whose fingers and toes were 4 and 20, 6 on each hand and 6 on each foot.
Hey, we got the giants had that, because the scriptures tell you about the giants. They said they used to be giants over here too. They found giant skeletons here in Ohio.
Yeah.
A lot of the giants was Canaanites, and the Canaanites have been known. They came over to the Americas before everybody, because they was the great shipbuilders and all that. You know what I mean?
Six on each hand and 6 on each foot, and he also was the son of the giant. But when he defiled Israel, Jonathan, the son of Shemaiah, David's brother, slew him. There were born unto the giant of God, and they fell by the hand of David and by the hand of his servants.
Because you know, when they built the pyramids, they probably had giants out there helping too.
Look, one of the apostles was bringing out over in one of the museums over up in New York. They found furniture, right? And the chair is like, when you sit down, the chair is up here, the button's up here.
Damn.
There's a dresser, they got a giant dresser where the handle of one of the dressers you pull out is up like there.
I believe it.
You know? And they got the shit in the museum, man. But people probably looking at it was like, oh, they just built something big, you know? Not thinking that then it was actual fucking giants using that shit.
We still got miniature giants today.
The giant, there's a, go ahead.
Oh, no, I was just about to say Andre the Giant.
Right. There was a, here in Ohio, there's pictures popping on the internet. I mean, I keep forgetting to download it. Every time I mention that, I forget to do it. But they got a giant sitting in a casket, leaning up against a train.
Right.
They excavated it, and they're about to move it somewhere else, but it's sitting up, leaning up, the giant sitting in a casket, sitting up, you know, a train. You walk into a train is up.
Yeah.
It's like at least 12 feet to get to the top of it, man, if not a little higher. And a giant is above. The whole body of a giant is lower than the train, man. This cray is a bugged out picture, man. But it's real.
Yeah, the giants were huge.
The femur bone, they got a picture of a femur bone standing next to somebody.
Did you watch that, did you watch that show Game of Thrones?
Game of Thrones, no. Because
people watch that, they just think it's fairy tale, whatever. But in that TV show, there's giants. The dudes got the like, it was like the equivalent of some Viking warriors. They was like the savages had Vikings with them fighting in their armies.
Right.
And you can see when the Vikings, when the Giants went in the battle, they was just plowing through motherfuckers. Can you imagine some Giants coming up on you with an axe?
Don't see it again.
Just
man.
Coming up on you with a big ass fucking axe swinging at you.
Right, right. What a sword.
And that's what David defeated a giant. That's crazy.
Right, he picked the sword.
Oh, yeah, and he got a sword. Use that big ass sword.
And his hands.
Yeah, he chopped his head off.
That's right, rolling the hands.
You know, his head, I bet Goliath's head probably weighed 100 pounds. You know what I mean?
We gonna see that again, man. He's gonna probably genetically modify some shit, man, because he probably went, of course he went and dug the bones up and took the genes out, took that giant gene out. You know, like,
oh, you know, he's probably trying to create something.
Just like he does with the diseases. He gonna dig up, he went and dig up the black plague.
Yeah, they got the black plague. Yeah, they got it.
So Esau's known.
They got the black death. What kind of fucking madman? We gotta get back to that Lucifer.
I got it.
Cause what kind of mad, that's him, that goes right back to Lucifer.
That's right.
That's Esau, he's the devil.
Like it says, that's where I left off at. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High.
Hey, he'd be like the Most High. He got the black death in the laboratory, thinking he can just contain it. You know, that black death, was not designed to be contained.
No.
It's going to get loose. Something going to happen. It's going to drop something. It's getting out of there.
Yet shalt thou be brought down to hell to the sides of the pit. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee and consider thee, saying, is this the man?
Oh, this was talking about Lucifer. So we know that Lucifer is actually a man. It's not Satan. It said, is this the man?
So,
and that's when we see Esau's destruction too. You're going to be amazed. He's like, is this motherfucker right here?
Right.
This weak bitch. This is the guy who caused all this chaos and confusion. Did you see them scientists and all that? They be like little nerdy little... It's the nerdiest, weakest, effeminate creature on the earth, and they're creating the weapons of mass destruction. You know what I mean? That's just bugged out when you think about it.
They
ain't nothing manly about it. They can't beat you in combat, but they'll create this iron.
They make some money.
They gonna make a missile and some crazy shit to kill you.
Chemistry, man, they'd use water and mix with something else to fuck your ass up, man. And they got all kind of chemistry experiments in YouTube.
Yeah, because Esau's a master of death.
Yeah. Shit you never would have thought of, man. Like, wow, man, you just mix them two in it to blow up.
Esau knows. Yeah, Esau be the one, he be studying the chemistry.
Yeah.
You go up in the chemistry classes, man, that's all Edomites up in there.
Right.
They just ready to learn how to make some drugs and make weapons.
They put it all on YouTube so everybody can learn.
Hey, that's good though. We should be learning all kinds of stuff.
Instead of looking for words of knowledge and understanding, these motherfuckers looking to play.
Our people don't use YouTube to learn stuff, learn how to do nothing. They watch YouTube to watch some booty shaking videos, watch some homie fighting videos, watch people get knocked out.
Yeah.
That's all they watch. Like, dude, that was funny. Just watching some foolish, some
stupid shit.
I be getting it in on YouTube, bro. I done learned how to do all kind of shit. I done became a master auto mechanic watching YouTube.
Watching YouTube.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You learn all kind of shit.
Yeah. YouTube. They that see thee shall narrowly look upon thee and consider thee, saying, is this the man that made the earth to tremble and that did shake kingdoms?
Yeah, so this weak bitch, he's the motherfucker that shook the whole earth. Because you see the men who were in power, they look like, what's that dude off the Simpsons? Mr. Burns?
The rich dude. Yeah.
Mr. Burns, that dude, the head of the nuclear factory.
The rich dude.
The rich dude. He's all weak. He can't even crush a paper cup. But that's who's running shit, is that guy.
Yep.
His people. Just weak as hell.
That did shake kingdoms, that made the world as a wilderness and destroyed the cities.
Isn't that what they do? They make the world a wilderness. Hey, you see what happened? Because they say it was the Esau that was behind that the tidal wave that hit Japan. They said it was a nuke. It detonated a nuke off the coast of Japan and hit it with a tidal wave. And now radiation spreading all over the earth. They're always spilling oil all up in the ocean. They said the Gulf of Mexico, they stopped talking about it. It was a blackout in the news. They say the Gulf of Mexico is all fucked up. Remember in the oil spill going back to, what was that?
Going on for months.
Like 2011 or something?
Russia told them to nuke it to stop them.
Oh, they did.
Yeah, they told them, they just holding it. They don't care. They didn't care, man. They know what they was doing.
That shit is everywhere.
Yeah. Russia told them to nuke it.
And you see the rivers, they polluted all the rivers. You're supposed to be able to drink water out of rivers. All the rivers is just death. It's not even water, it's just death.
Yeah, you see, these rivers are developing a green slime.
Yeah.
You know?
It's just nasty. It stinks.
Yeah. Right, right.
It's like a doo-doo river. Oh, they don't waste. Look at, they done turned a beautiful country, chopped all the trees down, and poured goddamn concrete everywhere.
Paradise.
They turned paradise into a desert. Now it's just a concrete jungle. You know what I mean?
That is paradise.
That's what I'm seeing.
Why would you want to, why would you want to just destroy all life and just create nothing? Well, they got some brick buildings. Wow. Those are destroying the earth.
Yeah.
I think so.
Moses. I swear I didn't understand nothing.
That's the Appalachian Queen.
It says Jeremiah 51 and 25. You hold on to this thing.
Same scripture. It's a spirit. Yeah, I was actually about to think of it. Now, I was go ahead and read it. I was about to get it. You know, that's just a spirit. You're talking about the defiled and where the world don't get.
Jeremiah 51 and 25. Behold, I'm against thee, O destroying mountain, saith Yahweh, which destroyeth all the earth. And I will stretch out my hand upon thee and roll thee down from the mountains, which are the rocks, or I will make thee a burnt mountain. And they shall not take thee a stone for a corner or a stone for a foundation, but thou shalt be desolate forever, saith Yahweh.
You got it.
Yeah, it's gonna be laid desolate, bro. All this shit's gonna be laid desolate. The Lord gonna purify the earth once again. And the earth's gonna be reverted to its true form, which is paradise. Okay, this is not the kingdom of heaven right here. This is a kingdom of filth. You know what I'm saying? Plague, confusion. It's a kingdom of abomination. Look at this shit, baby. Every time I come now, I can be cursing this shit.
Yeah, it's depressing. It's depressing.
All these buildings, all this. Everything's lifeless out here. You know, they want to do away with nature and create their own world, their own reality. That goes back to he thinking he the Most High.
His vision of a paradise.
Yeah. But the Lord created the earth perfect as it was. Look at this shit. You just look around with the camera. You see, they just changed everything.
The earth changed was the given into the hands of the witch. Are you only going to do what the wicked can come
you still with? On that same scripture?
Isaiah? I still got it right here.
Yeah, there's a lot more.
Let me read this. This is Ezekiel 4:12. And thou shalt eat it, and thou shalt eat it as barley cake, and thou shalt bake it with dung that cometh out of man in their sight. And the Lord saith, even thus shall the children of Israel eat their defiled bread among the Gentiles, whither I will drive them.
Yeah, because all of our food's defiled. We living amongst the heathens. The heathens rule over us. And all the food we get comes from them. You don't see our people with farms. You know anybody that owns a farm?
No.
And they providing their people with food?
No. My sister got a farm.
Do you know anybody with cattle that's supplying the meat?
Just keeping everything.
And the chickens? You got some good chickens, some nine? Hey, but that's what I tell you, that all the food we get from our slave masters. But people, everybody wants to say they free and independent. You ain't independent shit. You got your own source of food? No.
Everything comes from trucks.
Everything comes from
the yeah, shipped in. Yeah,
yeah, everything gets shipped in.
The trucks don't do it, then the water's gonna get dirty, the trash gonna be everywhere.
Right, so
medical supplies.
That's a good point. The economy collapses when it does. Look out here. This is a city full of millions of people. And there's no life out here. It's all concrete.
1.2 million.
It's lifeless. There's no plants. No vegetables, no cattle. It's all concrete and stone.
Right.
People going to starve to death. The only food that's going to be out here is going to be people.
Ain't nobody self-sufficient. Everybody's dependent. Dependent.
Everybody's dependent. Nobody's self-sufficient. Dependent,
you know, in a famine, we'd be able to survive for a little bit, you know, because we know.
And the Lord's dealing with, the Lord will bless you.
There you go, you know.
Because he'll make a way.
Job, is that Job? The death and famine also.
Yeah.
Whatever.
The Lord, if the.
That's a bad scripture too.
I think that's
a bad scripture, man.
The Lord will guide you.
Yeah. So we ain't worried, man. You know, we fast, you know, so we discipline ourselves to fast when necessary. That's another thing I want to bring up. I know the Day of Atonement is coming quickly upon us, man. I want to make sure I don't miss that because that's one of my main things. The Day of Atonement, man. The Day of Atonement. That's the day you get close to the Most High. Because we know that tyranny, that craziness is coming, you know? So that's the time to be praying for forgiveness, you know? And praying that the Lord have his wings on, the angels protect him, you know? Because this is about to turn into a hell zone.
It really is. Especially with the election coming up, the election season.
Oh, I can't.
It's just going to be vicious. It's already vicious. Every time they got a rally or something, there's all kind of protests. People getting the shit beat out of them. They got cops getting shot. It's already been happening.
It's guaranteed.
Shit's going to hit the fan.
That's right.
It's going to be all out chaos and confusion.
It's guaranteed. They're building up. This is like a like the pre-fight, not the pre-fight, but the Don King is out promoting the fight.
And Mike Tyson's out there talking shit. Right, I'm the greatest there ever was.
That's right, that's right.
You know what I mean?
That's right. Trump, I'm the greatest. I'm gonna bring this nation back to
Yeah, we're gonna make America feet. Great again.
They got the stinking bitch with her legs open stinking, talking about we're gonna make women equal with men, you know. This is just the pre-fight, you know?
And it tells you too, because what is it? Your boy Donald Trump, he openly calls Hillary, what is it? Hillary, the Crooked Hillary, he calls her. Crooked Hillary. And then you got everybody says,
hey, what's up, bro? My man. Go ahead.
So yeah, but everybody's saying Hillary's a criminal.
Yep.
And they're saying she needs to go to prison. Well, here it is. She's running for president, and half the damn country saying she needs to be locked up and executed. What kind of division is that right there?
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I can't wait, man.
And Donald Trump, they saying he's a racist. You know what I'm saying? They saying he's the so they pushing his racial division. That's good, though.
Says, let me get that joke too after this, but Ecclesiastes 12:1. Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not, nor the years draw nigh.
Oh yeah, so you supposed to be in the truth, way, you know what I'm saying, so way before the destruction, because when the destruction starts happening, then all of a sudden you're like, oh, the Lord, you really real. Now I witness, you know, bear witness to your power and all that. Mm-hmm. The Lord ain't trying to hear all that shit, man.
Now's that time.
You're supposed to do it before this shit hits the fan.
Eventually that door is going to slam shut.
You're supposed to be warning people about the evil that's coming.
Right.
That's why you're supposed to remember the creator ever since the days of your youth.
That door is going to slam shut, you know? Shut.
Right, everything you do in your life should be in the name of the Most High. Right.
It's going to be, that door going to shut. It's going to be a rule. It's going to close rudely too. It's going to close rudely. These people are going to feel stupid. Lord, Jesus, help me. Jesus, I'm saved.
Yeah, that's when they got the Bible out. When they watched the news, they seen the first missile hit or something. They got the Bible out.
They gonna catch allergies from all the dust on their Bible, you know?
All of a sudden, they were trying to get the missile scripture when the missile's on its way in the air. I mean, it's a little too late.
Too late. This
is Psalms 130:3. If thou, Yahweh, shouldest mark iniquities, O Lord, who shall stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou mayest be feared.
Yeah, because there's forgiveness with Yahweh Boss and Yahweh Shah. If you all this wicked shit you done did out here, it doesn't matter what manner of wickedness you did, the Lord is still forgiving. You could have done killed somebody, you know what I mean? But this is the shadiest shit imaginable. The Lord is still forgiving. Hey, most motherfuckers, they don't even care, bro.
They don't care.
I don't give a fuck.
Nah, that's the people with no faith. No non-believers.
Because they kill and they feel like they justify when they murder somebody.
Non-believers, yeah, it's justified. Through their own precepts.
And when they committed adultery and had sex with someone's wife, they justified it. Like, oh, he wasn't hitting her right anyway.
Yeah, he beat on her.
Yeah, he bit her. He hit her.
He was never even coming home.
He wasn't there for him. He was working too much. You know what I mean? She was lonely, so I had to take care of her. That's the type of shit they justify.
Yeah.
Like they did something good in the act of adultery.
Ain't that some shit? Oh, let me go back to this Isaiah. Come back to Isaiah.
Yeah, that's a good story. Look at this guy. Hey, could you tell me what you like about Hillary Clinton?
Could you please?
Have us a discussion with me, because that makes absolutely no sense.
Edomite.
He is an Edomite, bro. That dude wasn't even a Jake.
That was a chair.
Wearing it. And the dude's name is Cain. He's telling you he's the devil. Last day, goddamn Cain slew his brother Abel.
Ain't that crazy?
They throw shit out there like that on purpose. You know what I mean? They always doing that.
He looks like a piece of shit, too.
Yeah, he
look
does.
Look at his eyes, man. They look evil, man.
She looks evil. Well, she's the creepiest of them all.
You know that's right.
She's famous worldwide.
witch.
A hermaphrodite. Yeah, a hermaphrodite witch.
All the kings of the nations, even all of them, lie in glory, every one in his own house. But thou art cast out of thy grave like a fallen branch, and as the remnant of those that are slain, thrust through with the sword, and go down to the stones of the pit, and the carcass trodden at your feet. Thou shalt not be joined with them in burial, because thou hast destroyed thy land and slain thy people.
It's like as this country kills and murders his own people. You know what I mean?
The seed of evildoers shall never be renowned. Prepare slaughter for his children, for the iniquities of their fathers, that they do not rise, nor possess the land, nor fill the face of the world with cities.
So they got to pay for all those past crimes. They enslaved the Israelites. You know what I'm saying? Because America was founded upon slavery. They enslaved the Israelites, genocided the so-called North American Indians. And now, like the scriptures tell you, just went around the whole earth just raping, pillaging, robbing, laid waste to the whole earth. So now they gotta pay. They go drinking that cup twofold.
The scripture says there's never no peace with the wicked.
Giving to him double.
Yeah. Never peace with the wicked. The devil comes speaking smooth words, peace and love. Peace, love. Love, everyone. But that motherfucker is at home while you out here out and about. He at home killing your children. Or doing whatever the fuck he does, you know? Evil goddamn devil. I got some more of this. For I will rise up against them, said the Lord of hosts, and cut off from Babylon the name and the remnant of sons and nephews, said the Lord. I will also make it a possession for them. And pools of water, and I will sweep it with pools of destruction, said the Lord of hosts.
I got a precept for that. You done with that?
Yeah.
I got this. But this goes into the same thing about, you know, the almighty man. Esau thinks he's so great. You know what I mean? Psalms 52:1. Why boastest thyself in mischief, O mighty man? The goodness of the Most High endures continually. Thy tongue deviseth mischief like a sharp razor, working deceitfully. Thou lovest evil more than good, and lying more than to speak righteousness. Salah.
They're wise to do evil, but to do good, they have good.
Yeah. Thou lovest all devouring words, O thou deceitful tongue. And that's what Esau does with all the little fair speeches they be giving. Like with Hitlery, she be out there giving her, she gives that fair speech. Just blowing smoke up your ass. These people believe it, you know what I mean? It's so simple. They believe everything. They hear their preacher talk. He gives that fair speech because all the words are deceitful. Because he talks to you real nice, you know, like your little baby. You know what I mean? Like little lovey-dovey bullshit. And that's the shit that our people want to hear. They listen to the deceitful tongue.
Man,
the woman. Especially.
And the man going to follow the woman because he still went through between the legs, you know?
Yeah, but that's why the serpent went to the woman. You know, the woman is easy. It's easy to trick a woman. That ain't hard.
Easy. God, that's what you were talking about. God, she's bad. Bad. And that's what you find. That's what you find. You can have it, man.
I'll never forget this. Psalms 52:3. Thou lovest evil more than good, and lying rather than to speak righteousness. Salah. Thou lovest all devouring words, O thou deceitful tongue. God shall likewise destroy thee forever. He shall take thee away and pluck thee out of thy dwelling place and root thee out of the land of the living. Salah. So that's what's going to happen to Esau. Soon. Oh, you got something to say?
No.
Psalms 52. Yeah, they're going to get rooted out. America's going to get rooted out. Y'all thought, oh, we in this great nation. Y'all plotting on what you going to do in 50 years, talking about you going to send your children to college. I'm saving up for 20 years. I'm going to finally own my house. You know what I mean?
I think it's called a mortgage.
Mortgage. That means death, don't it?
Death note.
A death note. A mortgage, mortuary. That's the same word.
That's right.
That's death. That's why y'all all be getting suckered. You be taking out loans. you gotta pay back interest. When the laws of the Bible said that you're not allowed to charge people interest. That's how all these banks is ran by the so-called Jew. Because with Jews, you lose. Yeah, but they actually, go ahead.
Some of these people that got homes, man, they signed a mortgage. You spend the first 15, 20 years paying the taxes alone before you start paying them the house.
And he gives you in the sweet words. They come out with a commercial about why you need to get low with them.
Right.
They're like, we care about our people and our customers. And that's how they get your dumb ass. You know what I mean? Because you, the scriptures tell you you're not supposed to charge
sweet
people
words.
Usury, your interest. But this whole society is running on deceit. It's running on interest. Using people, taxing people. Here it is, you working hard as hell all week, you can barely afford to pay your bills, barely got any food, but they still gonna take all that money out your check. They don't give a fuck if you can eat or not. They still gonna tax you. But the word tax means to